Nasuha is a story written in 1960 by Sri Abdullah, winner of the Kendra Sahitya Akademi. Nasuha and Hatu Bivi are the main characters in this story. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Hypocrites, you must listen carefully to this story. This is for your own good. This is the story of Nasuha, who lived a sinful life. But this is just a story. Nasuha is a bit inhumane, a man who terribly cruel. If someone dies in that village or the surrounding area, he will go there at night like an eagle looking for the graves of the dead. He will take off the shroud that covered the grave and go. He's so brutal. He'll not tolerate even the dead lying in the grave. He did not even show respect for the month of Ramadan. He may be drinking when the Adhan was called. One day in the middle of the night, Hatu Bibi's angel arrived at Nasuha's house in a chariot. The angel informed him that Hatu wanted to see Nasuha. He left immediately. Hatu said to Nasuha, who came to him, "My end is at hand. If I die, do not come to my grave and harm me." Nasuha swore in the name of Allah that he would not harm Hatu. She was at peace. Then Hatu stretched out a mound which she had kept under her pillow towards Nasuha and said, "I brought this mound for you. Isn't this you are fighting for?" Nasuha said no and walked out. Hatu died the next day. Nasuha forgot what he had sworn in the name of Allah that she would not be harmed. At night, he dug Hatu Bibi's grave. The narrator says that what Nasuha saw was a scene of Hatu sitting in the moonlight inside the tomb reciting the Quran. Hatu then advises Nasuha that when he sees blood gushing from the bottom of Hatu's chin, she explained the reason. 20 years ago, I broke this small leaf's piece out of a neighbor's house without their consent. This is the punishment for that. After saying this, Hatu wished to him to request housewife to forgive her. On hearing this, Nasuha began to lament, "O most merciful God, please forgive me." His face fell down in remorse. The voice of Allah shone on those still frozen lips. No matter how big the mistake, those who do it may feel guilty at some point. We must be able to correct such people rationally. God does not reject those who approach Him with a repentant heart. The narrator tries to give us some messages like this.